Hey guys, welcome back to episode number 32 of the Minecraft Multiplayer Let's Play series. As you can see, there's been a slight change to Casey's house, and Casey has been informed she is losing her house because of this slight change. What slight change might that be? Well, let's show you. Whee! Guess what I need to do? And there's a cart right in the way. And... yeah. I have a feeling I'm going to hit that plate, and I'm just going to go backwards. Let's find out. Whee! Guess where I get to go? The opposite direction. This is so much fun. Anyway, the point of this wasn't to show you guys watching me go the wrong direction in my cart, and I just lost my minecart again. Alright, that's it. I'm going to walk this. Maybe we can catch up to the minecart. Probably not. No, in my luck, it's just going to teasingly stay out of our path. We'll destroy that minecart. We'll hop in this one here as we push it, and there we go. Now, what we've done here so far, guys, is we wanted to show you guys what the idea is. This is going to be the minecart station entrance. This is going to lead us down here, where Casey is patiently waiting for her turn to go back up so she can finish making a new house and move to her new house, which is what we're trying to get done now. We've opened this up like we told you guys we were going to, and now we have a few decisions to make, and we're going to have this as a group decision and as a group video. Let's be honest here. I could make a minecart station with a bunch of redstone and a bunch of switches. We're going to require a considerable amount of work. Or I can just make 5 minecart lines with signs on each line letting us know where they head to. And we can do this for every single station. What do you think, Mark?
I say we do a combination of both.
No, it's one or the other. There's no both in this.
Let's see here. The switches, we would have no idea where we're going until we learn.
No. With the switches, I could do the same thing. There could be a switch right here on the block, and above the block is a sign leading to Main City, leading to Spoonville, leading to Spoontown, whatever we want it to make it be. But it's going to require a lot of redstone wiring and a lot of work to get done. And I mean a lot of work to get done. Or we could simply make rail lines like this that all come in here into one general area, and each line leads us out.
Sounds good.
And simpler.
I got slime balls. Slimes seem to like our town, I guess.
Alright, just leave these alone for now. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this room is not exactly... that's 9. Okay, so the room is not exactly set up. We could do one more. We got to make this wall one more deep, Mark.
Okay. I'll work on it.
Yes, as the fans can tell, I have my server set up to automatically save every so often. This should be obvious by now. It's simply for a safety feature. If something happens to the world, there are consistent, persistent backups to the server. And we don't have to worry about when was the last time we backed up, because we just backed up 15 minutes ago, or so, and so forth and so forth.
Alright, I remember that.
Okay, so this way now we can set up 10 individual lines, each with their, hopefully, their own booster. Like that. And then what we'll do is we'll actually set up this line back here. It won't come in like this. It'll turn right here and come to us. Five, six, seven, so we can go two more, which includes the turn. The turn we're going to lose considerable speed on, but that should work. Now, with any powered minecart, powered rail as they're called, like you're going to see here, you always need a redstone circuit underneath. I'm at a smooth... I do have some smooth stone left. Without the redstone underneath, the redstone torch, that would not be powered, making it pretty much useless. But I actually screwed that up, and that's not a big thing. That's completely my fault. It actually has to turn back a spot. But unfortunately, as you can tell, there is bedrock here, and that does create a little bit of a headache for us to work with, but it's not undoable, it's just a general headache.
Now, where was that one that you put down? Like right here?
Sure.
That was right.
Alright, so now what we do is when you come down here, you come in the first one, it's going to push you all the way down here, and you're going to stop. These powered rails are only there to see for now. And then there will be signs behind, and actually what we'll do is we're going to pull these out a little bit. So give me a second here. We'll set this up as if it was a true train station. You come in here, and sign will be right about there.
And the sign is saying, do not read this sign.
Now, over time, you're going to question it off the bat. Well, you can't have everything go straight. And you're right. We'll have one go straight, and then the next one will go straight and turn. The third one will go, maybe it'll go up and then turn a different direction, and so forth and so forth. We'll spread them out so that it works properly. Right now, this is just us showing you a rough idea of what we have planned. Then the logistics of us actually getting it together come into effect. So we will see what happens. This is just a start, again, to what we're having planned. We're going to take a break from videos for a little bit. We're going to actually do it. We're not going to keep showing you every little thing we do. I know these videos seem a little shorter, but again, it's hard to do full videos right now. I want to thank you guys for watching, and have a good one.